Hi there, I'm Kezia Tanesha, and I'm a second year student in Oxford studying engineering. I'm gonna show you a realistic day as a student here, and this is during lockdown, so I really hope it's not gonna be boring. Today I wake up at 6:30 and I wash up, I reflect, and I usually just play some songs to start the day. Today is going to be a long day. My grandma just passed away yesterday, so I've got to attend a service from the UK, and it starts at 7 o'clock in the morning here. So yeah, I think that's the bad thing about living far away from your family. After that, at 8:15, I usually just go through my iPad into my calendar and also my emails, sometimes making a to-do list for the day. This helps me to focus and not miss anything. As you can see, I'm doing a little happy dance here. I just got an internship offer and I'll be using machine learning for cancer diagnosis. I think I deserve a pat in the head. It's a bit rainy today, but I think it's really nice. So I'm just walking towards my favorite spot in the whole building. And by the way, that lamp is quite cool. And that's enough relaxing for now, because I need to start on my lectures.
So we have a total of 4 joints. That's why we call it planar, 4 arms.
For engineering, we have 2 lectures every day, and each lecture lasts for about 1 hour. And today I'm going to do 2 lectures. The first one will be about mechanisms, gears, kinematics, and the second one is turbo machinery.
Velocity ratio. There is no slippage. In this
After my beauty sleep, I just ordered some food for lunch, and while waiting for it, I usually do my puzzles, play my games on my phone, or play my Rubik's Cube. And then I'm just eating while doing my Zoom meeting. Please tell me most of you guys also do this. By this time, the room feels very stuffy, so I'm just packing everything and thinking about going somewhere else to study. My mom always nags me to take my vitamins, so it's good that I actually got this on camera to show her that I'm actually taking them every day. Off we go to the kitchen.
Hello.
And another short studying session. I was just opening the lecture notes and trying to recall what I have learned from the lectures in this morning. Now it's 2 p.m. and I'm having a meeting with the Southeast Asian Countries Societies for an upcoming collaboration project. After the meeting, I decided to take you guys on a little tour around Oxford because it's time for grocery shopping.
Let's go.
Cool. The nearest grocery store from my dorm is actually just 10 minutes away. It's really close to Tesco, Sainsbury's, M&S, you name it. And this is the Smolian Museum, my favorite museum in Oxford. And that one is the Randolph Hotel. But sadly, both of them are closed during the lockdown. I hope everything gets better so that they can open for visitors again. I finally reached Tesco's and now I'm gonna show you what are the things that I usually buy and how much they cost in the end. All of those sums up to about £20 or 350,000 rupiah. Here I'm just gonna check my pigeonhole for a while and I didn't have anything there. I'm kinda sad, but it's okay. I'm just going up now and going to unpack everything that I've bought. While I was walking back to the kitchen, I just saw this beautiful window and I just want to brag a bit, you know, about the weather today and how beautiful the building is. I was so happy that my friend was making pie tarts, so I just helped her a bit before I study. Back here again in front of my laptop. This time I'm gonna be starting on a new consultancy project. I've just been enrolled into Oxford Strategy Group Digital. So in this project, I will be using machine learning and data science to analyze around 200,000 songs from Spotify and make a report about it in the end. I think this is a really good start to learn about machine learning, so I'm really thankful for it. And yep, you guessed it, it's another meeting, but this time it's not just a regular meeting, this is actually a tutorial that Oxford and Cambridge are known for. In the tutorial, we have only one tutor and two students, so it feels like a very private lesson. At the start of the tutorial, I usually tell the tutor what are the numbers that I'm struggling with, and then we'll discuss it together. Usually, we use the virtual whiteboard as well, as you can see on the screen there. And then he also sometimes asks me about some questions just to check whether I truly understand the topics and the cheat sheet that I did before. The paper that we were discussing was the paper that I did last week, which is about time frequency. Trust me, you don't want to hear me explaining about the Nyquist limit theorem or the autocorrelation of a signal. Thank you. Bye. 6:30 p.m. is usually my dinner time, but this time I won't be cooking anything because I know I'll be having some snacks and movie night with my friends later on, so I'm just eating my biscuits with some cheese. And by the way, if you're wondering what app I'm using for studying, I use GoodNotes and I recommend it so much. It changed my life. This is literally the city center of Oxford. You can see almost no one here. and it's finally 11 p.m. at night. Here, I was just contemplating whether I need to study more or do my other project, but I decided to just shower and go to sleep. Because I usually have such busy days, this is actually the only time where I can spend my time to do something else, like reading the books or comics. And then I also usually just open the iPad to read the Bible. I would pray and then go to sleep because I need to be energized for tomorrow morning to do another day. So thank you for now. I hope it's not too boring for you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!